is Yanni Hubick from Natal. He drives another Scott. If you saw us coming live this morning from Middleburg, you'll have seen just how he does drive a motor. Just gone past our commentary point now. You can see the oil cooler in the boot lid there. These are locally developed cars. The engine is made in Brits. The cylinder head is cast in Brits. So it's an all South African motor car, this, with a very, very high local content. And this has been one of the mainstay cars of South African rally. They sound glorious. They're spectacular. They're pushing out about 175 horses through those back wheels. Look at this control. Just look at that control. The power coming through those back wheels. He goes left and right. This looks like going to the bar. While he's saying left, you go left here. He's going up to the finish, and it'll be his third position, second in Class B, and third position overall. But now it's Hubick as some of the others come out. Oh, no, it's the little conquest of Eric Saunders. There's Eric Saunders, a great performance in Class E, which is a class for cars between 1600 and 2 litre, and that's the little Toyota RSR. It's a 1600, 16 Velva. He's gone very well since he's been in this car. Almost unbeatable. He's lying second in the South African Rally Championships at the moment, and he's well on his way. So if some of the leaders, as Serge Damsous has done, start to lose their points, Eric Saunders could become the South African Rally Champion this year. Great performance. This is a little RSI. A very good little all-round motor car. Does good. Does very well in standard group in racing, the saloon car racing, and does equally well in rally.
Eric Saunders is a Springbok tydrenjaar wat reeds 42 jaar oud is. Hy het in 1974 met sy tydrenloopbaan begin en hy het sy Springbok klere in 1979 gekry nadat hy 8ste geëindig het in daardie jaar se internasionale Skotse tydren. Hy en sy navigator Tilo van Westerhagen het byna ongelooflike 6de posisie algeheel gekry toe hulle in die in hierdie jaar se Tour de Vauvelin in Alfa Port Elizabeth deelgeneem het. Zo ook dan Tilo van Westerhagen. Hij is een jongman, 28 jaar oud. Hij komt hier van Pretoria en is reeds al 5 jaar bezig met zijn tijdrenactiviteiten. Een groot actie daar zo van Eric Saunders zullen. En let even op naar die verschillende bestuurders of stuureigenskappen van die motors. Dat nou, die motor heeft natuurlijk voorwielen aangedreven, tegenover die achterwiel en die vierwielen aangedreven motors, wat ons reeds gezien.
Putting up a great performance. You see the concentration on their faces. They're Eric in the clothing manufacturing business and getting that back wheel up in the air. You see it locking at times. They use the handbrake. Just some news, incidentally, on some of the others. The favourites, if you haven't been following this rally, is Serge Damsous, who was up and down. He'd won already 2 stages and tied one with Sorrel Funameva during the night. He went out with a steering rack that had broken, and the reason for that, he got 2 punctures and kept driving as fast as he could, and eventually it thumped through and broke the steering rack. So that was Serge, unfortunately, out through a mechanical problem like that of really trying to press on. Hannes Strobler, another favorite in that very spectacular skyline. He had trouble with the electrics, mainly the alternator, and that wasn't able to provide enough power for the lights at night, and really could only hobble along in the dark forest around Sabi and Nelspruit. Johan Evertzer going very well in the early stages. He won one of the stages early on, as Eric Saunders, spectacular in that little front wheel drive car, pressing on as hard as he can. Just news on Evertzer and Steve Harding. Their engine management system went on the blink and the car wouldn't produce power. In fact, it had no power to pull it up some hills, and they had to pull up. Here he comes, Eric Saunders, going very nicely. Look at him pointing there. No, you go that way. No, you go this way. And here he goes as the driver just presses on. They're all belted well into these motor cars. They've got lap straps and thigh straps, so they feel part of the motor car and can feel everything that it is going to do. We've got Glenn Hall. This is a giant killer here. He's in the Volkswagen Golf. He's done very well. Wait for him to come out. He's coming out. There's a smaller car this time. Done very well in this rally as he comes into South. That's Glenn Hall with Martin Buerta. There he is, giving a great performance in that, in his Class C motor car.
Glenn Hall en Martin Buerta, wat ook hier na die einde van hulle tydrense kante staan, manne wat baie, baie moeg moet wees op die oomblik. Hulle is die voorlopers in Klas D op die oomblik, en vijfde algeheel is Glenn Hall en Martin Buerta. Gesê, hulle is baie moeg. Hierdie manne jaag al van gistermiddag 12 uur af, dwars deur die nacht, met so hier en daar 1 of 2 kans om te rus. En een besonder goeie vertoning hier deur Glenn Hall en sy navigator Martin Buerta. Ook een voorwiel aangedreven motor hierdie, een Golf GTI met 16 clip engine. En hulle het deur die loop van die tydren bietjie van posities verander. Aanvanklik was hulle bietjie verder terug. Hulle het opgeskuif daar na die vierde plek en op die oomblik dan in die vijfde plek al geheel. Jy kan sien hoe gebruik hy daar die handrem as hy daar dan deur die draai gaan na links. Die rook die borrele agter die agterwiele uit om daar die motor se ster so vinnig as moontlik om te kry. Voorwiele aangedrewe motor natuurlik moeilik om vinnig om 'n skerp draai te kry omdat die voorwiele geneig is om die motor se neus te trek in die rigting van waar hy waarheen hy oorspronklik beweeg het. Met ander woorde, die mens moet so 'n bietjie hulp gee deur middel daarvan om die voet van die versneller pedaal te lig en miskien so ook die handrem so 'n bietjie op te trek. Jy kan sien daar die regter agterwiel heeltemal in die lug soos wat hy daar om daardie draai gaan. Uitstekende jong bestuurder hierdie Glenn Hall waarvan mense nog baie verwag.
Giving a great performance there. This is the end of the Westbank Rally. They've done just over 1100 kilometers since noon yesterday. This is the 28th stage and they've done 512 kilometers in the rally with over 28 stages. Well, you're going to be back a little later with us in the afternoon just to confirm the results, but here you are. This is the